I have a couple more subtraction problems here for you. Now, before we dive into these, I want to talk about how our new definition for subtraction works with some of the rules we already know. Specifically, I want to look at this one. Negation distributes over addition. This isn't a new rule, this is just the distributive property. You have the negation of the sum, you get the negation of the first term plus the negation of the second term. If we look back at our definition of subtraction, we see the addition of a negation is a subtraction. So I can write this side over here as the negation of x minus y. All I've done here is taken this plus the negation of y, turned it into a minus y, because that's our definition of subtraction. Now we see what we're doing here is when we take the negation of the sum, all we're doing is flipping the signs of both of the terms in the sum here. You turn this x into a negation of x and this plus y into the negation of y. But now I want to take a look at what happens here when we stick a negation in for y. Let's take a look at that. And what I mean by that is if I start here, and instead of having a plus y, I put in a plus the negation of z, what happens? Well, still, we go ahead and distribute this out, distribute the negation, we'll get minus x plus the negation of the negation of z, and all we're doing there is distributing the negation. Now over here, x plus the negation of z. That's subtraction. So this is just x minus z. And what's going on over here? Well, we still have the minus x, the negative x here, and the negation of the negation of z, well, that's just z. And look at that. We've taken the negation of x minus z, and that becomes the negation of x plus z. We've just flipped the signs here. We take the negation of x minus z, we get minus x plus z. All right, so this in mind, this is really nothing different than what we already know. This is just the distributive property. Let's move on to our two subtractions. Right here we have negative 15 minus 28. That looks exactly like our distribution of negation here. We can just go backwards. Negative 15 minus 28. We go backwards, and that's going to be the negation of 15 plus 28. And we can check ourselves here by looking at it going this way. Negation of 15 plus 28, that's minus 15 minus 28. 15 plus 28 is just 43. So our answer is negative 43. And we're done with that one. On to the last problem. Oh, this one looks a little trickier. It doesn't really look like either one of those. Wait a second, check this out. We're going to go back here and look at this right here. I can use the commutative property to reverse the order. All I'm doing here is switching these two. So instead of negative z plus negative x plus z, I have z plus negative x. And z plus negative x, that's just subtraction. You add the negation, that's the same thing as subtraction. That's z minus x. So the opposite of x minus z is z minus x. The opposite of 37 minus 89 is 89 minus 37. In other words, to solve this problem, I can look at this subtraction, 37 minus 89, as the opposite of 89 minus 37. And that's easy to compute. 89 minus 37, that's just 52. So our answer is negative 52. And we're done.